Hi, I'm Kit Von Riley, and I'm here today in Gresham School in North Norfolk to learn about the new craze that's been surfacing all around Europe, moonball. Right now, I'm here with the founder of Moonball, also the Moonball director here at Gresham School. Sam, how did Moonball come about?
My father, as you know, was a moonballer. My grandfather was a moonballer in Sweden, a Weibobian in 1840.
Wow.
And he's one of the first people to bring it across on the ships. But we've been playing it professionally, so I got two caps. But it's the first, only been with the school, I think, a month.
Sam, what are the ins and outs?
It may seem simple to the naked eye, Kit, but it's a complex game of rules, regulations, grey areas, and assorted goals.
Moonball is an adaptation of hockey, but instead of a hockey ball, you use a moonball. This makes it unbelievably more difficult, as it's just so goddamn bouncy. Right, if you're in goal, and you're the goalie, you can clear the ball with your foot. If you're on the outfield, and it touches your foot, that's fine, but if you use the foot openly to kick it anywhere or do a maneuver, it's not all right.
Moonball is a very modern game. The rules are still evolving. What are the rules like on physicality, Joseph?
So, being derived from hockey originally, moonball had no contact to begin with. However, as the game progressed, we found it more and more interesting for it to become a full contact sport. In its current state, the rules are such that as long as the player has two hands on the stick, physical contact is fully permitted as long as the hand is not used.
Very interesting, so almost like a rugby-hockey hybrid, if you will.
that's the way that some people see it, but really we see moonball as its own derivation, as it strayed so far from its original sources.
Well, that's, I can agree on that. I think it's a very unique game. Thanks, Joe.
Thank you very much.
I'm here now with Digby Wheeler, part of the first five moonball. Digby, what are the positions like in moonball?
Well, it's interesting because the swain, which I have here, is an interesting position in that you stand by the goal and catch the ball in the net, where you then hit it as hard as you possibly can into the goal. Or you can use it as a defensive tool. You also have the floater that drifts by the goal and waiting for the ball to come at them. You've got the centre midfield, which is basically the person that goes around and hitting it as hard as they can up the pitch. That's basically it.
So, a traditional and modern sport combined. It's got everything. I'm here with the first team moonball, and I'm lucky enough to have an actual match ball itself. Charlie, tell me something about it.
This is a finest Olympic standard moonball, fourth of the season. Absolutely perfect. Absolutely.
Well, what else can I say? Let's play moonball!